Jeff Keaton, 32, and Andrew O'Dwyer, 36, volunteer fireys and young fathers, their children born just 2 days apart last year. They were on their way to fight the Greenwattle Creek blaze south of Sydney when their truck was hit by a falling tree, killing them both.
It's a tragic blow for their families, for the RFS extended family, and of course for the entire community.
Simply went out doing a remarkable job like all their colleagues and like they have done year in, year out.
It's just an absolutely horrendous thing, and I can't imagine how difficult it is for those families and that community today.
With the men's colleagues in mourning and flags flying at half-mast, the tributes came not just from officials, but from you at home.
They are true heroes who gave their lives to protect others.
Rest in peace, you beautifully generous and brave humans.
They should both be given state funerals.
Jeff and Andrew were two of the more than 200,000 volunteer firefighters across Australia, ready to drop everything when the call comes in. Some of them fighting to save the homes of strangers while their own homes burn.
They're ordinary, everyday individuals like you and I that go out and simply want to serve and protect and make a difference in their local community.
Few of these selfless Aussies would have ever anticipated they'd be locked in the near constant battle they are now.
And that's why we need to do more to make sure that people aren't out of pocket.
The RFS does provide compensation in the event of injury or death, so Jeff and Andrew's families will be covered. But right now, there's no compensation for the valuable time volunteers take off work and away from family duties.
There's a range of measures that could be looked at, whether it's tax breaks, whether it's one-off payments, whether it's some form of leave payment, support for businesses that are allowing people to leave.
With heat records being repeatedly broken and the fire threat only growing, so too are the calls to do more for our volunteers.
Well, Craig Burley is the Hawkesbury Group Captain with the RFS, and he joins us now. Craig, it has been a very tough day for the fireys. How are you holding up?
The RFS is a family. We feel it really deeply today. Very sad for the families and very sad for the people that have had to deal with the incident on the ground.
And that's just one aspect of the toll that it takes, of course, Craig, the emotional toll on fireys. The other issue that's around is the financial toll that it takes on volunteer firefighters walking away from their jobs, their businesses, giving up day after day to do this. What sort of financial toll are we talking about on firefighters?
Oh, look, it's significant for sure. The every day we're not at work is a day we're not earning money. Employers let their employees go, so there's a financial toll that goes right down the scale. I work for myself, so when I'm not in the office making a dollar, I'm on fires. So the financial toll is significant, for sure.
Craig, what's the most important thing you need people watching now who are directly or indirectly affected? What do you need them to know?
Need them to know that, in particular, tomorrow is going to be an extremely challenging day. Just found out a few minutes ago that the Greater Sydney region and the Illawarra are definitely both gone into catastrophic fire conditions for the day. So that means that if a fire occurs and starts running at assets, assets will probably not be able to withstand that impact. So the best message that folks could do if they're in a bushfire prone area under the catastrophic conditions is move out of the road, and we'll do our best to protect their homes. However, if they're in a bushfire prone area and they decide to stay, is to maintain good situational awareness. Listen to the local radio, the ABC radio. Hopefully everybody's downloaded fires near me. Hopefully everybody's done their survival plan, but perhaps if they haven't, tonight's a really good time to talk with your spouse, talk with your children. This is what we're going to do, and set your triggers for when you're going to move out of the road so that you're not leaving it till the last minute to make those decisions, because at that time it's probably too late.
Craig Burley, thank you so much for your time tonight.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
If you want to help the families of those two brave firefighters that were killed, you can go to a GoFundMe page. A campaign has been set up there. Head to our website for all the details.